The U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention opens an office in Manila. A U.S. Embassy statement says the CDC is committed to advance shared health priorities with the Philippine Health Department. The CDC's acting country director in South Africa, Dr. Romel Lacson, will serve as the agency's first country director for the Philippines. The Philippine Health Department and its U.S. counterpart also signed a memorandum of understanding to enhance engagement on health and medical science.
The risk of monkeypox spreading widely among the general population is very low. That assurance coming from the European Center for Disease Prevention and Control amid growing fears of the virus spreading among the wider public. So far, less than 200 confirmed and suspected cases have been reported since early May in Australia, Europe, and North America. But the World Health Organization says the outbreaks in non-endemic countries can be contained and human-to-human transmission of the virus can be stopped. Monkeypox, which is not usually fatal, can cause a fever, muscle aches, and a chickenpox-like rash on the hands and face. No treatment exists, but the symptoms usually clear up after 2 to 4 weeks.
The Philippine Health Department heightens its monitoring of monkeypox. During a briefing with President Duterte on Monday, the DOH said it has adopted a four-door strategy in intensifying border control to keep the virus out of the country.
Ating pagtitibayin ang screening process sa ating mga borders upang maiwasan ang pagpasok ng monkeypox sa bansa. Ating din pong hinihimok ang mahigit mahigpit na pagsunod sa ating minimum public health standards.
While Philippine health officials see a slight uptick in new COVID cases in the country the week after the elections, the country averaged 173 new infections from May 16 to 22. This was 9.9% higher compared from the previous week. Six COVID deaths were also confirmed during the past week. But local researchers believe the increase was not brought about by the recently concluded polls, but because of highly infectious Omicron subvariants that have been detected recently. Meanwhile, in business, a dire warning from the International Monetary Fund. During the World Economic Forum in Davos, IMF Chief Kristalina Georgieva said the economic horizon has darkened. She said the global economy is facing what she called its biggest test since the Second World War, the fallout from the pandemic, Russia's invasion of Ukraine, and supply chain issues. A bright spot, Georgieva said, is that right now there is no clear risk of a global recession.
We have downgraded our projections for growth for this year in April for 143 countries. This is 86% of global GDP. And since then, in a short period of time, a little bit like the weather here in Davos, the horizon has darkened. We are looking down this 2022. It is going to be a tough year. We have commodity price shock in many countries, and the particular shock I want to bring your attention to is food price shock.
In April, the IMF slashed its global growth outlook for the second time this year to 3.6% from 4.4%. It cited the ongoing war in Ukraine and rapid inflation as clear economic risks for many countries.